Okay, so today I'm continuing with the psychrometry application in air conditioning system. And I think in the previous lectures, hope you understood the basics of psychrometry and psychrometric processes. Assuming that you know or you have now understanding regarding the properties of air and various psychrometric processes. So air conditioning, as we all know that air conditioning is nothing but it deals with conditioning of the air as per the human comfort with respect to temperature of air, humidity of air, purity of air, and motion of the air. So in order to create a comfort condition inside the room, you have to control these four parameters. But whether all these four parameters are sufficient. So yeah, if you can see this cartoon, you will see that only putting air conditioning inside the room will not help you. For air conditioning, apart from these four parameters, which are they? Temperature, humidity, air motion, and purity. The other psychological as well as the environmental conditions are also equally important, because air conditioning is a technical as well as psychological thing which makes you comfortable inside the room. So you can see in this cartoon that though air conditioning is good, that air conditioning is producing some noise. This noise may be because of the malfunctioning of the fan, or the fan bearing, or the noise created by the fan. And also the occupants and what they are doing, their activities also affecting the conditioning of air, and some animals are just wandering here and there and creating some noise, dripping of the water from AC inside the room. And the noise, particularly noise, is also important. Apart from these four parameters, you have to also control the noise inside the room so that the person or occupant inside the room will feel comfortable. But we are only going to deal with the technical parameters. So here is a few actually recommended air motion, because the fourth parameter is the air motion inside the room that is responsible for proper air conditioning. So you will see that air movement, air motion is given in CFM, cubic of feet per minute. And you will see that for dining room, you require 20 CFM, for bars 30, hotel and conference room 20, office spaces 20, then beauty shops, then ballrooms, it is 25, residences, it may, for residences as well as for retail shops, it is given in air change rate that we'll see afterwards while designing the air conditioning systems in detail. I will tell you what is mean by air change rates. Okay, so you can observe that as per the different applications, the different air motion or air flow rate is required inside the room. Okay, and generally it is given in cubic of feet per minute. Now, classification of air conditioning systems. So air conditioning systems are broadly classified as follows. Firstly, it based on the purpose. So first is comfort air conditioning, and second one is industrial air conditioning. So I think the first comfort air conditioning implies that this such type of air conditioning systems are used for creating a comfort inside the room for the occupants particularly. Now, And industrial air conditioning are for particular specific applications like packaging of various tablets in case of pharmaceutical industry, or for CNC applications where you have to keep the temperature of that machine in control. So in such application you can use industrial air, or such type of applications are called as the industrial air conditioning systems. Now second is according to the season of the year. So we know that as per the season our air requirement is changes, and particularly the temperature and humidity related to that air is different in different season. So if you are using air conditioning in winter, then it is winter air conditioning. For summer, it is summer air conditioning. And year round air conditioning is of course deals with, so it will handle the air conditioning throughout the year. Am I audible now? Hello? Am I audible now? Please text me. A few students are not getting my voice clearly. So please reply if I'm getting your voice. Whether my voice is clear or not, please leave a message. Now, check. Okay, fine. I think my voice is clear now. So, year-round air conditioning itself explains that year-round air conditioning is Year-round air conditioning system deals with, or it handles the air conditioning throughout the year, irrespective of the season or as per the season demands. Your air conditioner is in a position to supply the air as per the occupant's requirements. So, as per the season, you may say winter air conditioning, summer. And third is as per the equipment, is the unitary air conditioning and central air conditioning. Unitary air conditioning system. Unitary air conditioning systems are for a confined space. Say you may say one room, two room, or few rooms only, and each room. Sorry, because of some technical glitches, I'm not able to continue. Hello? Am I audible now? Am I audible now? Okay. So unitary air conditioning system, examples of unitary air conditioning system are window air conditioners and split ACs that we all know. And the central air conditioning, the name implies central air conditioning means such type of systems are used for large air conditioning applications where you have to condition the large space multi-floor building. So such type of application is, such type of system is employed in these applications. So for example, city center mall where central air conditioning system is employed. Now I think you can identify it or which type of air conditioning system is this. So this is the window AC. As you can see that the box is fitted in on the window, and one half of that box is inside the room and half is outside the room. So such type of box you observe, which is quite old nowadays, very few places you observe such kind of system. But this is one of the widely used air conditioning system where half of the portion is to supply cold air inside the room, and this red indicates the air from the room is again sucked back to the AC, and which is then conditioned, and blue line indicates which after conditioning the air from the room, that fresh not fresh, that conditioned air is then supplied to the room again. And this is the nowadays this is quite popular system known as a split air conditioning system. So the name implies that split AC. Okay, the split means now in case of window AC, you observe that the system is totally fitted inside one box, okay, which is known as the window air conditioning. But now this window air conditioning is divided into two parts. It is split into two parts. One is this rectangular section which is fitted inside the room, okay, which you can with the help of remote you can change the airflow rate, temperature, and the second part is such type of split ACs are now quite popular. Next is I will just show you if you are able to see this clearly. Such type of AC is also you observe, which is known as a cassette AC, because in this type of system the total fan coil unit evaporator section is fitted in the false ceiling. So such type of systems are known as a cassette AC, which you can observe in hospitals in most of the cases. So next one is the chiller. Such type of chillers you observe, the chillers are used to produce a chilled water. It may be at 5 or 7, 8 degrees Celsius chilled water, and this chilled water is then supplied to fan coil unit, which is evaporator, and that evaporator then cools the air. So such type of chillers are used in a central air conditioning application where you have to handle lakhs of liters of air. So winter air conditioning, so in winter air conditioning systems you can observe that in winter particularly the condition the outside or atmospheric condition of air is quite cold and dry, clear? And so in order to treat that air, which means you have to increase the temperature of air as well as humidity is less, so also humidity So for heating and humidification process, so outside fresh air is taken through this damper, first pre-filter, and this filter is then am I audible? So this filter first filter out the dirt. So purity of air is important. So after that, it goes to preheater. After preheating the air, it goes to the humidifier. Clear? And because as I told you, in winter, heating and humidification you have to do. So heating, preheating, then humidification, and then again reheating, and then with the help of this fan, you can supply that air to the conditioned space. So purity is with the help of filter. Then conditioning of air with respect to temperature and humidity is done inside this section. And after that, air motion is with the help of fan. So these are the basic components of any air conditioning systems. And in particularly in case of winter air conditioning system, it is done with the help of heater and humidifier. And that conditioned space, part of that air is supply again recirculated back to the room, and rest of the system is rest of the air is then exhausted. Okay, it depends on your application. You can change the amount of recirculated air as per your convenience. Okay, so in few cases it is 10% or 20-30%. You may go up to 50% as per your application. In summer AC, in summer, I think outside air is quite hot as well as humidified. So what you have to do is you have to cool the air and as well as dehumidify the air. So cooling and dehumidification is the psychrometric process you have to do in summer AC. So again, outside fresh air is taken. First filter that air. After filtering, cooling, cool that air. After cooling, if your coil temperature is less than the dew point temperature, so cooling and dehumidification takes place. And after that, again, you need to heat that air. Okay, why to heat that air? That I will show you on psychrometric chart. And then with the help of fan, you can supply that conditioned air to the room. So let me show you that